What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. How are you guys doing? I want to say a big thank you to all of you, my subscribers. If you have not subscribed and you're watching this video, what are you even waiting for? Click on the subscribe button, please. Thank you so much for the love on my previous video. I love you guys so much. If you've not subscribed, please subscribe to this channel. Please like the video, dislike the video. If you don't like it, it's okay. You can't always like everything on YouTube. Share this video, drop a comment. I would really like to read from you. Thank you so much once again. So on today's episode, I will be talking about being a bastard. Yeah. Once upon a time in my life, I actually called myself a bastard. I came to realize that I am a bastard when I was a child. Let me not confuse you guys any further. Comment below if you have ever thought you were a bastard because of the warm training that your mommy gave you when you were growing up as a child. Brethren, I chop beating. You know, there's a particular beating that you will chop. Translated in Yoruba, there are some particular iya ti o ma je. That means that you will chop. It will reset your brain. Your brain will, you will start doing good. By the time they beat you, and 1 week later, your body is still paying you the mark. You know, when your mommy tell you, pay my dad pass here, Lara, brethren, run for your life. Or when your mommy tell you that my dad said, yeah, you see, Seria Nye is the senior brother of Akpa, because Seria is greater than Akpa. Akpa is Mark. Seria is Panebitin. Look, this is the distance between Seria and Akpa. You see, for the Akpa own, for Akpa, you can recover. For Seria, by the time they finish with you, you will faint. Brother, if you don't faint, it is definitely not Seria. Comment below if your mommy does area for you as a child. So when they finish panebiting your life like that and you almost cannot move your body for a week, that's when you will start to convince yourself that no, I'm a bastard. Definitely it cannot be this woman that born me, because how can she born me? I hate to this much. Comment below if growing up your mom panebited your life and you thought you were a bastard. Yo fam, the good news is you are not alone. They panebited my life. I'm just so happy now that God has been so gracious to me. Hallelujah. I didn't have any mark on my body, because I actually thought that those marks would not leave. I was so scared at one point in my life. Look, there is a particular level of beating that your mommy will beat you. You will convince yourself that you're a bastard. Brethren, on to this episode, I just hope that you'll be able to remember your childhood experience and comment below if you ever like experience some of the things that I experienced. And basically, let's just laugh together. This particular day, once upon a time, my mommy told me to go and buy shower fish. No, there is a way that my mommy often specified the shower fish. Look, shower fish is a sweet fish. It can be made. You can use it to prepare moi moi. You can use it to do stew or soup or anything. It's a very versatile fish. Anyway, my mommy always tell me to buy shower fish that has egg in it. That's how that they are now be going. Yo, week where I should go and buy shower fish and let me, and now stop by at Radonic workshop. If you don't know Radonic, or you didn't have Radonic in your adubo, that means you are an algebra. Oh. You see, a Radonic workshop is a workshop that they often abandon radio, television, VCD, DVD, cassette player, or rishi. Maybe you are only the Radonic and you have not paid. We hold on to it until you pay. And they also turn it to cinema grand. Because at night or in the afternoon, whenever the radio new places, it will start to play film for us and we will start to watch on the street. So I stopped by there because they were showing an interesting film. Comment below if you watch Diego and Paloma. Did you see that series? That series made me to chop came from my mommy and you. That's why I stopped by there. I was watching the film. Then it turned on me like, yo, my mommy tell me to come by shower and ledger. Whoa, I japa. When I got to the shower place, I totally forgot that I was supposed to tell the woman that I wanted to buy shower fish that has egg in it. That's how I bought ordinary shower fish. Brethren, this is the... Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. I go back home. I gave the fish to my mom. First of all, she was like, Ibololola taro. So I was trying to calculate the lie in my head. Don't lie. It's a bad thing to lie because they will catch you. One mamu, eh? That's how she didn't, she just ignored. Of course she knew I was lying, so she started to clean the fish. She now see that there is no egg in the fish. You see the way she called Julia. I knew that there was a problem, because if you hear O behind your name, just know that you're a goner. Shumba, goner senior, go. You will chop the beating of your life. That's how Anna started to say, mommy, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. You will start to confess all your sins and trespasses. You see, the worstest mistake you can make in your life is to call neighbor to come and help you to beg your mommy. Ah! You can't see me. Eh? You have just added to your problem. You don't know. I was talking to a friend of mine. I said, why do they all behave the same? So we concluded that they must have the same WhatsApp group, they must have attended the same Bible school or membership class or something, because they all behave the same. Anyway, my mom didn't beat me that afternoon. She waited for me at night. Ah! Comment below if you have chopped midnight beating. You see, midnight beating is what they call seria. She beat hell out of me. The next morning, I made up my mind that I was a bastard. I said, I convinced myself that I'm a bastard. It can't be this woman that bombed me. The way she punished my life. So I now start to plan that I'm going to run away. Comment below if you ever thought of running away from home growing up as a child. Yo fam, you are not alone. I planned I'm going to pack my things and run away, but when I didn't realize where I can run to, I now changed my mind. That's when I started starving myself. Yo, I starved myself and my mom will keep eating. I'm not one of those people that my mom, I'll be fasting and starving or saying I don't want to eat and my mom will not start begging me to eat. She will never do that, fam. She will leave you to starve and by yourself, you will change your mind that, I will see more by you, oh, Tito. Then by the time you now make up your mind that you want to eat, she will not ask you, she will think, biri biri eton, translated, have you finished your dry fast or have you finished? What's that translate? I don't know. Oh gosh, so that was what made me. It was that beating of that day that made me convince myself that I'm a bastard, because the beating was so crucial. No, sorry, critical. Oh my god, another thing, another childhood experience I have with my mom is, look, there is this thing that mommies used to do that used to vex me, which is the fact that they will know that they don't want you to eat in somebody else and they will carry you and go there. Why tempt the Lord our God? When we not reach there, we will sit down on our own, jeje. Then the alejo will not say, kini kafishe in la alejo, translated, what should we offer you? My mommy will not say, ask her. You see that, ask her, if the mom you were saying something, you are a goner. You will not shake your head and say no. They will not, the woman will not insist that, mommy, let her eat now. She will not go and bring food. You see, when she go to the kitchen, if your mommy look at you like this, your brain will tell you what she's trying to say. When the woman brings the food, you will not say, no, I'm not eating. And in your mind, you fantasize the food. In fact, especially if the food has a nice aroma. The woman will say, mommy, and she say, eat now. Why are you not eating? You know that if you touch that food, you are a what? Goner. So I used to wonder, why take me to this place if you don't want me to eat there? Or why tell the woman to give me food if you don't want me to eat the food? You know what I mean? Another thing that my mommy did for me as a child, you see, brethren, honestly speaking, by now, I supposed to be a billionaire. If you know the amount of money my mommy is owing me, honestly, you will tell me to sue her. Is it growing up as a child? If somebody dies you money, ah, you just know that it's your mommy that will collect that money. There was one thing that my mommy did for me that I can never forget. Comment below. Do you know kolo alamo? Hey, brethren, there are different types of kolo. Kolo can be called a special bank in your house within the confines of your room that is in a box. Okay, I'm sure you guys know what kolo is. Look, there is kolo nipangolo, that one that we have milo bonfita, and there is kolo alamo. Brethren, I have kolo alamo. It is very hard. Kolo alamo. The kolo made with clay. Right? It's very hard to pick up money from that kolo. So the only way that I thought you could bring money out of it is to break the kolo, which I usually leave to December so that I can buy Christmas clothes and do my telephone wire. Oh my God, comment below if you made telephone wire growing up as a child. That was a trendy style, you know? That's how I didn't know I'm saving money. I didn't know that my mommy was removing my money. How did she remove the money though? Because you have to really consider. Up until now, I still cannot wrap my head around how my mom took that money from my kolo alamo. Yeah, because when I broke the kolo, brethren, the kolo was empty. I started weeping, yelling, crying. My mom said, what happened? I said, mommy, I cannot find the money in my kolo. Guess what she said? She said she borrowed the money. You know that when your mommy borrows your money, you can never get it back. I said, crying. I said, mommy, how did you remove it? That's when she will now start to tell you the story of your life. Story like how you were born, the food that you eat yesterday, the clothes that you wear yesterday. And you will now start to ask yourself, mommy, if they didn't dash me money, sure you will not train me. There's one last one I want to share, and that's Agbo. Brethren, you know that there is there is Agbo and there is Agbo. My mom is the number one Yalagbo of Africa. Yes, my mom will not only give me Agbo, she will give my friends Agbo. Like when my friends come to call me for school, my mom will give them Agbo. Agbo, how can I translate Agbo? Agbo is herb. Herbal medicine. Combination of Ewe and Tebo. Oh, somebody should help me translate what Agbo means. Right? So my mom will force everybody to drink Agbo. My friends were literally scared of coming to my house because my mom will always make sure that they take part in the Agbo. You know what I mean? And it was so bad that when you fall sick, by the time you drink the Agbo, the next time you want to fall sick, you will think twice. You see, my mom is not one of those fancy mommy that when you say, Oriwe, don't do it, that means your head is spinning and your tummy is spinning, they will rush you to hospital. No, no, no. My mom will sit with you and give you correct Agbo. By the time you drink it, the sickness will fly off. I have to... If I want to go on and on talking about my childhood experience with my mom, I bet that I can keep talking for an hour, for 2 hours, for 3 hours, because it's endless. I just really think that mothers are amazing. A big shout out to every mom out there. Comment below, let me know if you had the same childhood experience as mine, or if your mom did these things to you. Tell me anything your mom did to you as a child that made you think you were a bastard. And you just wanted to run away from home. I would really love to know. And tell me if you had the same childhood experience as mine. I would really love to know. Please give this video a thumbs up. Please like this video. Please share this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. And please turn on your notification bell. Take care of yourself. Until next time, be well.